Hello, what's up guys? Today I'm going to review a beatbox portable, which is not really a beatbox actually. Dr. Dre beatbox actually. It's not really that one. It's just a Chinese replica of the beatbox, which is a portable actually. So what they've done, they downscaled it and made it portable, exactly same sort of feature, same sort of design thing. But the sound quality, obviously it will be a bit of compromisable. And you're looking at about buying it for less than 20 pounds. So less than £20. So that's pretty good for that one. You know, it looks pretty decent. It takes a FD card and all these things. So let's open up the packaging and I will be also playing a little bit of music on it as well, just to make sure to understand, you know, what sort of sound quality you are getting on it. So let's open up the box. Boxes are pretty good. As you can see around it, they had made a really nice box, you know, just to make it much better in terms of design wise. So design of the box, I'm sorry for that. And inside what you got is your beatbox, which is just right here. It has got two speakers right in the front. So two speakers right in the front and also a passive radiator in the middle, and with the beat logo in the front of it. Exactly by the quality of it, you can see that. How does it look? You know, it looks pretty good quality wise. And on the top, you have got a Beats by Dr. Dre logo on it. And also play, power, play, attend a call, and a power button, multifunction button right on the top. And also next to it, two multifunction button, which controls the volume and also the, like a side of a change or preview sort of options, you know. On the back here, it's got an auxiliary port on it and a USB port on it. This port is just for the charging purpose. If you're going to put an external device, let's upon your phone or anything like that, you can charge it using this one. And a micro SD card slot on it, which you can see on the top. That is for if you wanted to put the songs in your micro SD card and you can hook it in. You don't need any Bluetooth connectivity or anything like that. So you just put all songs in your micro SD card and play it around by using these all three buttons on the top. And this works as an MP3 player as well. And as this is the charging indicator light, and also the Bluetooth status connectivity light too. And right there, it's got a mini USB charging port. It's got a mini USB charging port on it. So that's the first. This is what the speaker you're gonna look like. As you can see, that the quality wise, it's not that bad at all. Looks pretty decent quality. And the second thing comes in the package is there we go. No instruction manual whatsoever. Your auxiliary cable, simple as that. Pretty decent auxiliary cable, normal one, and a mini USB charging cable. So what we're gonna do now, we're gonna just start it up. Well, I will consider this as a standard. So what I'm gonna do, I'm just gonna press the power button here. Power button is pressed. It's got a notification. As you heard, it's got a notification sound, and it looks like, and it's got a Chinese woman speaking on the back. Well, it's not a very clear English, being honest with you, but doesn't matter anyways. So it's just, you know, enough to understand. So I'm going to start pairing it up. So I'm going to start the Bluetooth on my Samsung. There we go. It's on. Bluetooth is on. So, okay. I'm going to look for this. Okay. We're going to search for that. As you can see, if you can see that. Okay. And scan for the device. Just looking for that at the moment. Okay, go. It came in the bottom here, right there. You can see that at the moment it came up with the MAC address. Now you can see it's got a B11 is called. So you press that button. Once it's paired, you will hear the notification. There you go. A Chinese woman again said paired. There you go. That's nice, not bad. So now I'm going to play some music on it. So I have got some music on it, which is royalty free. I don't like to play the music which is with the royalty, honestly speaking, because I will end up getting problem from YouTube itself. So I'm going to play some music right there. So there you go. I'm going to put it right here, and the music is just in the front. So first music. Music music quality wise is pretty decent, you know. It's not that bad at all, honestly speaking, as you can hear it. So this is royalty free music, and I also increased the volume as well. You can, if you got a device which is a non-Bluetooth device, and or like MP3 player with auxiliary port on it, so what you can do, you can use the auxiliary cable which is also provided in the packaging, doesn't matter. And if you got a micro SD card with the songs in it, you just hook the micro SD card with the songs in it, there you go. You can play with it all right here. It automatically selects the mode, you know, you don't need to press any button to select the mode at all even. So let's play some music. Bass is quite settled bass. It might be the possibility that I'm putting on the wooden place, wooden surface, that could be creating a very nice bass as well. But let me lift him up a bit and let's see what bass we get. Exactly same music. Not really big difference at all, you know, not really big difference. So it's pretty good in terms of that as well. So what I'm thinking, you know, it's a pretty decent speaker, and it's a price is fair as well. If you wanted to give someone as a gift in this Christmas or something, you know, it's not that bad. You know, a kid could be much happier than with having this something like that, you know, with the Beat logo in front of it. So I don't think so, is there any problem. And in terms of other speakers, which is right in the front of it, they look like it's they are actually 3-watt speakers, both of them together, the 1.5, 1.5. Because I'm guessing it because of the sound quality of it. Other than that, because it do not have any instructions, so I can't really tell what it is in there. They just send me a couple of speakers like that. You say, can you review them for us, please? And put the link only for the advertisement purpose. That's what they've done. So what I'll do, I'll put the link on it so you can check the quality of it, you know, check the what sort of what they are, you know, and you know what sort of what you call they have got. No, sorry, I'm talking about the volume on it, power on it. Hey guys, you can see once the Bluetooth is connected, this LED will indicate you the when it's blue flashing, that means it's connected. Otherwise it's a red and blue, that means it's wanted to be at paired up. Have you seen that all now? And hopefully, if you got any questions, I hope I have covered everything of it. You know, it's just these are Bluetooth speakers. They stand, you know, they're all the same. Some of them, you know, changing a bit of music and all these things. But for the price and everything, this is a pretty good speaker, I would say that. So if you got any questions, please do let me know and drop right below in the comments. And if you like my video, please hit the like button. And also, if you don't like it, press dislike button. I don't mind. And please hit the subscribe button as well for more videos in the future, because I've got a couple of speakers lined up here, which is from Audio Dynamics V2, Autumn V2, and there's some watches as well. Some of them send me and watches as well, so I'm gonna do them all review now. So thank you very much for watching this video. I hope you like it. Cheers, bye.